Have you ever wondered when you visit a website where those words and images are come from? How the internet actually works? When you're chatting with others, playing online games, or sending email, or even you can watch YouTube videos. These days, as long as we have internet connection, we can visit billions of web pages that are present over the internet, and we can do video calling and even YouTube live streaming a lot more over the internet. Let's figure out how it works. Before entering into it, let me know some interesting facts about internet quickly. On an average per second, 5 lakh comments, 2.5 lakhs views, 5 crore messages are sharing on Facebook. In Google per second, 5 million searches are reporting. On WhatsApp, 3.5 crore messages are sending per second. On YouTube, nearly 5 crore videos are watching per second. Based on this, you can imagine how big the internet is. Before going to know how internet works, let us know a brief history of internet. The internet actually got 50 years ago. Scientists and researchers used it during Cold Wars. In 1962, a scientist named Licklider proposed an idea of network of computers that can talk to one another. In 1969, the first ever message sent from one computer to other was a network of computers called ARPANET. ARPANET is the government network at that time. ARPANET stands for Advanced Research Projects Agency Network. The first message sent through this ARPANET between two computers, one is at Stanford and other is at USCLA, and the message sent was login, but it receives only first two letters L and O. In 1991, a computer programmer named Tim Berners-Lee invented World Wide Web. He was the man behind the World Wide Web. He also invented HTML. Over the years, many web browsers come into game and change the way we look at the internet on your smartphones, laptops, and your personal PCs. This is some brief history of internet. Let us know how it actually works. Many people think that internet is come from satellites or from cloud services. Yes, totally wrong. 99% of this internet traffic are exchanged using the optical fibers. Remaining 1% is from satellite. This 1% is also because of GPS, which are used in Google Maps and some other companies like Ola, Uber, etc. The internet cables are spread all around the world through oceans, connecting one country to another. These are called submarine cables. They are made with glass or fiber. The size of this cable are very small than human hair. The video you are seeing now on YouTube is reaching you through any one of these optical fibers. Whatever information you search over internet or any web browser is divided into small packets. These packets are converted into pulse of light or radio signals. These signals went through a device called router. The router sends these packets to their destination with an unique IP address of your computer or any other device you are using through these optical fibers. After fetching the information you required, the information comes to your computer through these optical cables, looks like a little packets of code. It does not make sense to most of the people. We need a translator, something that translates packets of code into words and images on your website. For this, we use a web browser. It translates the information and make it useful for us. But this code is come from somewhere, right? Yes, it comes from other computers, not a regular computer, but one built to make a web page available. It is called server. These servers are also computers, but how different are they exactly? Well, any computer has some basic components, processors, working memory, storages, etc. But that doesn't mean that you can use your desktop computer as server. Server memory has higher capacity of storage and gigabytes of RAM. But connecting your computers to all other computers around the world through these cables is not possible. So you can use the cables which are already present. Some big companies already made the connections connecting countries all around the world, like AT&T, GTT, Level 3 companies in USA, and Tata Communications in India. These companies built their own cables several years ago. They are called Tier 1 companies. To get more information about this cable, visit submarinecablesmap.com. Now go to Google and type submarinecablesmap.com. These are the cables that are connecting all the countries around the world. In India, there are 6 landing stations at Mumbai, Cochin, Trivandrum, Chennai and Puducherry. These are the cables owned by Tier 1 companies like Tata Consultancy in India. All the information that you search on internet, whether sending or receiving, is went through one of these 6 landing stations. Recently, Reliance Jio also launched 3 cables to countries like Africa, Europe and America. That's why Reliance Jio is giving internet for that low price. Tier 2 companies like Airtel, Idea and Aircel buy data from these Tier 1 companies and transmit data through towers which are set up in local area network. To know more about how it works, open command prompt on your computer and type TRACERT and whatever website you want. MiniElectronicHub.com. This is our website. This is the IP address of my device. From this IP address, the data is transferred to this IP address, broadband.actcrop.in. This is the IP address of my internet provider, the router of your local area network. From this IP address, the information is sent to loading. It will take some time. This LAN internet provider comes under Tier 3 company, and from this Tier 3 company, the information is sent to hyderabad.vsnl.netin. Sent to Hyderabad. This is the IP address. And from the Hyderabad, the information is sent to Chennai, one of the landing station of 6. From the Chennai, it is sent to Singapore country. This is the information you search on your internet. From your local area network, all the way it travels through Singapore. To know more about internet, go to submarinemap.com and type the country which you want. Despite of massive growth over the technology and internet, there are still 9.5 billion people who does not have internet. European countries have on an average 75% of the internet, while other African countries have only 20% of the internet. So few technology companies are filling this gap, like Google use balloons called Project Loon. To give data to these backward countries over internet. And Facebook also use Project Aquila using solar powers. These solar powers send radio frequency internet through air. But all these have some drawbacks. These solar powers store energy during daytimes, and during night times they have no power. So guys, if you like this video, please like it and subscribe to our channel for more interesting videos and Arduino projects. For web development videos about HTML, CSS and JavaScript, visit my website minielectronichub.com. Here you can find projects about Arduino, circuit designing and HTML. Thank you for watching this video.